Welcome to Mudding with Beagz. This is episode 35. I sure appreciate you showing up and taking a look at what I got to show you. I'm going to look at a few mudfloody old world photos today and see what we can learn about our history and kind of shake the sand out of our ears and our minds and see what we can find out. In other news, when a civilization decides that it's okay to beat the shit out of a woman on national television, it's collapsed. I'm just saying. Also this week, I guess some of us learned that cathedral ceilings are actually a little easier to build in wood and plaster than it is stone. So that's something good we should know. But, you know, it's kind of pretty simple, you know, if you think about it. It'd be a little bit cheaper if you would build it out of the wooden plaster than it would be the stone. But, you know, I guess we all have to learn in our own way. And basically what I have to say is, you know, no shit, Sherlock. I think that that's pretty simple. I mean, you know, it's kind of obvious that, you know, they're not all built out of stone, you know, so, you know, maybe do a little more research on, you know, maybe the big ass doors and how difficult it is to actually build these effing buildings, the materials used and where they were manufactured and the amount of skilled labor and such thing as that. That would be the next thing I would look into. The roofs. Yes, some of them were wood and plaster, and some of them were stone, and some of them were stone, and then they had wood roofs over top of them. Yes, we already know this. This is, like, known. There's nothing special or interesting or different to learn here. Okay? It looks like stone. Whoop-de-effin-do. Okay? Let's move forward. Come on, man. I'm more worried about what's below that roof. Okay? Look below the roof, down, you know, down and get down in the mud, man. Jesus. Anyways, forget all that mess. Beagle, roll them credits. Let's go mudding. All right, here we go. We got Arcade Market, the arcade building in Washington, D.C., I believe, circa 1913. And an arcade is what we would refer to today as a mall. I don't know why they called them arcades, but anyways, this is a Moorish-looking building. And there is Fred. Fred is the horse that built America, one of the horses. But Fred is the creme de la creme. He's the head horse that's going to get it done. And these are arched windows, so those are definitely old world. These windows right here that open on this swivel, I think that's part of a wind-catching system. And in the end credits today, I've put in a new GIF of how a wind catcher works. So stick around for to see that in the end. You can get a better idea for, instead of trying to understand what I'm saying, you can just look at the GIF and it'll
explain it. There's a ether antenna, got ether finials here. These tiles right here, roofing tiles, they possibly could be made out of clay too. And if they are made out of clay, they need to be added to the brick count, because they would have had the same type of process as the bricks, I do believe, to be constructed. So you're going to build this beautiful building right here, and then you're going to put this horse shit right here, this arcade sign, over this beautiful decoration right here. So y'all thought about this when you built the building. Okay, which came first, the arcade sign with the building, or the building and then the arcade sign? Think about that. Does that make sense right there? You think they couldn't have come up with a better way to do that? Why didn't they take this arcade sign and put it like right here? Wouldn't that make more sense? That way you could see this beautiful decoration. Why are you going to build this building and then put all this decoration here? Or, I mean, did some fool just really think that decoration wasn't worth seeing anymore? I mean, who's writing this narrative? It's crazy. Archduendus, this right here is a half 8-point flat earth asterisk. So you just mirror this image on the bottom and you have your flat earth asterisk. You got your vertical right here and your horizontal flat plane of earth, and you got your torus field right here. So that is a flat earth asterisk. What else can we find up in this place? Look at that. That's pretty right there. Very pretty. They had so much detail in the old world. That right there's got a, it's hard to tell, it's got a little bit of telltaleness of pavement lights. See that square right there? I can't confirm it, but that could have some pavement light in it. Not easy to confirm there. Anywho, I've got a, oh, this is interesting right here, right? Look at that, this round shape. What, you know, was this, which, you know, was this open before, or did they design it like that? And look how that, the bricks are rounded around here, around the side of that building. That's really cool. And look at the detail here, all these arches. So, like, ridiculous for this time frame. How you would spend that much effort. These probably are part of a wind catching air conditioning system. So would the chimney. That would be part of the air conditioning system. And by air conditioning, I'm talking about heating and cooling of the building. And I have another shot of this building. This one is in 1925. So a little bit further down the road. And you could see, you know, you got your ether antenna right there. You got this weird doodad here. This is interesting. What's going on here? What is this thing? I don't know. I mean, it could be a radio tower, or I don't know. But I mean, you know, what is this? I mean, that some kind of ether finial? I don't know. It's weird. And back over here, you got some kind of big building back in the back. Big old columns right there representing the torus. You got a flat earth asterisk right there. That is the symbol for flat earth. They're telling you what kind of earth you're in. That was a known thing, so you could see it better right here. Clear as day, flat earth asterisk. It's all over the front of that building. They want you to know. These are interesting. These are, I can't tell if these are hollow or like if they're open. Or if they're glass, that's kind of weird because glass wasn't that clear back then. So it makes me wonder if this is open. If it is open, that's weird. I mean, that's a transom with no glass in it. It's just strange. Very, very weird there. I don't know. 10 cents, 15 cents. Man, things were cheap. Okay. Of course, we got cheap things now. It's called Walmart. Hello, ladies. Hanging out a window, I see. Well, that's normal. Got flower decorations. See, there's that corner again. That's really wild how they loop around that, curve it around. Look, they even do it to that stonework there on that facade. That's interesting. We'll put up some horseshit signage. We'll get at that. I believe these big old windows are part of the air conditioning system. You know, this is our technology, this ladder right here. That's high tech for us. We can handle a ladder, no problem. We got that. We got Moorish architecture. We got that, no problem. No worries, hakuna matata. Well, I sure appreciate y'all joining me today in this video. I know your time is valuable, and I haven't been able to do this for a little couple a week or two, something like that. I have been in the process of trying to upgrade my computer systems, and that was an epic fail. Got new equipment, and the damn thing was faulty. And I spent a week trying to fix the damn thing. Finally gave up and shipped it back to them. So, looking at different equipment now, and hopefully we'll find something better, because the if I don't know how much you guys know about computers, but I'm running a horse and buggy computer compared to what I need, and it literally cannot keep up with what I'm doing, and it's really surprising that I can do what I have done with what I have. So hopefully we're going to rectify this shortly, and see where we can go with this thing, because I've got a lot of stuff I want to do, but I need to do better with my technology, because it's not good. Circa 1903, Sand Street entrance, Brooklyn Navy Yard. And that's just a cool picture. I have to say, oh, brick counter. Now I need all this. I don't, is that brick? I don't know. We'll count it as brick. Why not? You know, they got enough brick roads around. Might as well count that. I love these little newsy pictures. So great. That's Boss Man right there. In case you want to know where Boss Man is. Some people like to know where Boss Man is. Keep an eye on that Boss Man. Look at there. That's been covered up. They patched up that hole. Look at that intricate work right there. We got a castle here in Brooklyn Navy Yard. They got porthole. Look at that. Tell me that ain't a weird looking thing. Look at the curve. It's just curved right around there into this, into that work. Oh wow. Look at the intricacy of that thing. I mean, that is not novice work. That's pro stuff right there. Arc light. I mean, look at this turret thing. Eagle on a ball, aka that's a phoenix. In esoteric terms, that is a phoenix. The calling it an eagle, and it is an eagle, but it represents the phoenix to the esoterics. It's an eagle is an exoteric idea. It's for the masses. The masses looking, they go, oh, an eagle on a ball. Oh, that represents America. Wrong. Equals phoenix. Just saying. I mean, this is a pure castle, this thing. Good grief. This is supposed to be the Navy Yard, because the Navy needs a castle. I thought the Navy rode ships. Look at that wrought iron fencing. Ooh, I'd hate to get poked by that thing in the tail. Man. I mean, look at this fella. Look how decked that fella is right there. Spick, spotless, spanless. I mean, good gracious. Okay, we got to move on. We got to move on. We got 1912 Baltimore from the Emerson Tower. So if anybody's from Baltimore, you know what I'm talking about, then you know what the Emerson Tower is. I don't know what the Emerson Tower is, but I bet it's probably big. There's a radiator. I believe radiators are old world technology. I believe they are a leftover technology. I believe the whole steam system was left over. These are just me thoughts. That's just me thinking. I've talked to people that have been down in the steam tunnel. They actually work in the steam tunnels, and there's things going on down there that are that's a etherfinial fencing, ether antenna there, right here. In case you need to see that. Look at that, just the intricacy on the top of that radial building right there. I mean, seriously? Check that out. What in the world is that? That's odd looking. Is that a like a dove cat house or cage or something? That's freaky deaky right there. I don't know what that is. Okay, let's get down here and see what we can see. Got some construction in the road, maybe putting in a trolley line. There's an entrance to the underground right there. Boom, right down the hole. Boom, don't fall in that. You might get mudflooded. And that right there is probably pavement light, but I can't confirm it to you. That is telltale looking pavement light right there. I mean, you got telltale signs, several. You know, you got this underground, obviously. I mean, you can see there's a freaking door there. And then you've got this dark, heavy line here in the right place that a pavement light would be. It's got telltale signs. You've got probably more of that here. So that's probably pavement light business there. Got arched windows. More arched windows. Look at this right here. They got doors that close up on the windows. Look at all those arch windows there. Blumberg Brothers. Wow, this picture just goes on up, on up, on up. Big old arched windows. Big old, got a searchlight up there. Got an ether antenna. See what else we see. Got a smokestack. Ain't no smokestack. Check that thing out. Ether antenna there. Arched windows. Look at portholes there. Look at, man, look at the cornice on that thing. Hoorah. Damn, that's some nice work. A fella can appreciate some work like that. Look at the arches. Jeez. If you see arches, I mean, it's old world. We didn't build those arches. It would be so hard. Look at the size of that door. How big is that damn door right there? That thing's huge. That's a monstrosity of a door. Wow, that is pretty right there. How they did that, man. Okay, grief. Okie dokie dokie dokie. Let's see what we got here. Bull Durham. I love that movie. See, I'm from Raleigh, North Carolina, and Durham is the next city over. And I used to go watch the Durham Bulls play their baseball. We used to chase baseballs underneath the stands, and the people would pour the beer on us. We'd come home and get yelled at for smelling like beer. We didn't drink. We were just kids. Them arch windows. Okay, we're going to put these arch windows in there. We're going to brick this one up because, well, that makes sense. Anytime you see a bricked up ass arch window, you know there's some hanky-panky going on there. I mean, you need some mud flood? I mean, what's this right here? Can anybody answer that question? You know what that is? That's a big ass door that they didn't want to have to explain, so they blocked it up. That's what that is. And there is Fred right there. Fred is the horse that built America, in case you didn't know. Yep. And yes, there was, Fred did have some help by some tracks of the trains and stuff like that too. But Fred is going to get credit because Fred is the horse to build America, and that's just that. And if you can't get that idea about coal hole covers and windows and doors below ground and how that's just stupid, then you don't, you know, need to be doing this research. You need to go home. you know, can't hang with the big dogs, get off the porch. That's pretty right there, old Keystone Arch Winders. The quality shop. I see old Jared Booster's got him 16,000 subscribers out there this week. Good for you, Jared. I'm proud of you. That kid, he's got good chops. I like that kid. He's good. He's good peoples. He does good research. I like old Jared Booster's. Let's see. We need more Jareds out there. So if you're out there and you're in doing this research and not even a lot of you, but some of you out there are going to be like, you know, myself and Jared and Campbell and Martin and, you know, all these guys. You're going to get this research. You're going to be like, at some point you're going to be like, you know what? I got something to say about this. I got some fresh ideas. Well, we want to hear them. So get on the YouTube and make you some videos so we can learn from you. Because we all got fresh ideas. I got some ideas and you've got some ideas. Everybody got some ideas about this thing. And through, there's an ether antenna. Through looking at different ideas, we can all come to a conclusion, you know, to new ideas and new conclusions. And we can uncover this holy mess of what we've got going on here. Because I can't do it all. There's enough of this research to go around for many, many, many people for many, many, many years. Don't worry about stepping on nobody's toes or not having something fresh and new to say. You start doing your own research and start making your own videos. And you will find that you can have a voice. Anywho, Scrub Cartouches, let's get back in here. I've got a dome right there. Good grief. Ether antenna there. Another dome. Look at that. You got a cupola there. Some portholes. This could be a part of a wind catching system. The air would shoot down. You know, it seems like they had mainly one big opening and then a smaller exit. But there's always, from my understanding, an entrance and an exit. And they are designed specifically per region. And they could open and close trap doors, basically, and make the air flow in different ways. You really should look into wind catchers. It's very fascinating. And it'll really spark your imaginations. Look at the horse shit right here. Now that is very weird right there. You got a big old arch right there, which is red flag. But then you got a water tower up here. But then you got the back off this thing. I mean, look at that thing. Does that look right? And then we got a ladder link. See, this is our technology. We can do a ladder. Mr. Contractor can make you a ladder. You know, Mr. Contractor. Look at the good grief. Look at the arches down there. Damn, this is crazy. Look at those big old columns there. Big old torus field right there. Good grief. Big old antenna right there. Man, this place is crazy. Look at that. Look at that cornice work right there. Look at all this trash in the road right here. What in the world? And as always, the pictures will be in the descriptions. I don't know if you guys go look at these pictures after I'm done rambling my mouth. You may not. That's a cool looking building right now. I ain't never seen one like that. What a weird freaking building. Okay. But yeah, I don't know if y'all go look at these pictures or not, but I always put them up there. That way you can go do your own damn research. You don't have to believe a word I say. Matter of fact, don't believe a word I say. Go do your own damn research. I'm just sharing you what I find. You can agree with me, you can disagree with me. That's okay either way. At least you know, if you look into it yourself, you've made up your own damn mind. And that's what matters. That's what matters. Clocks are expensive. Very expensive back then. You imagine how much a clock would cost to build, the gear mechanisms and all that hoodra. My goodness, look at that. God, I can't take it. Got some construction here. I mean, yeah, we did construction. Yeah, had to fix all this shit that was broken from whatever the takeover mechanism was that where we took all this place over. Look back there. What's going on back there? This is a hell of a picture. Man, I like it. Okay, let's move on. I get stuck in a picture. And we got circa 1915. This is Catholic University in Washington. Guessing D.C., but I'm not sure. Main building. And that is a big building. Got an ether antenna there. And you got a flat earth asterisk right there. Which came first, the flat earth asterisk or the cross? Let me think. Just a thought. Got Moorish looking here. That's that Moorish look right there. We added these stairs right here. Got mudflood windows down here on the bottom. In case you want to see some mudflood. Yep. Old mudflood. Big old arch doorways. Look at this doorway right here. Now that's odd, right? Look at that. That's odd. I bet you this is brick underneath. You get up underneath this skirt right here, you find some bricks. Got a porthole there. I bet this is an old wind catcher system here and they blocked it in somehow. Covered it up. Converted it to, you know, let's burn wood in a fireplace that's not a fireplace. But that is a pretty building. That is pretty. Alrighty, let's move on. Cleveland, Ohio, 1906. Cleveland Gray's Armory, a volunteer militia that saw action in the Civil War. The Cleveland Grays built the Sandstone Castle as a meeting place and social center in 1893. And they call it a sandstone castle. Does that look like sandstone? Why do they say sandstone castle? I mean, okay, maybe that's sandstone there, but I see a shit ton of brick. That's what I see. Also see brick road. Mr. Brick Counter, add that brick road to the brick count. And I'll tell you from my research, this right here, this door, you open this up, this wood panel door right here is not original. And there's stairs inside here, and the actual door is inset, and it's on the level here. So you go upstairs to get to the door. So this is the second level up here. And there's something below here. And this little church here is gone. They got rid of it. Big old arch doorway. That could be part of a wind catcher right there. Got your ether finial right there. And I do believe that this Cleveland Gray's Armory, which it was not an armory. Whatever it was, it won't no armory. Like a castle. I think it was much, much bigger than it is today. This thing's still there today. But I think it was, if you look at old pictures, it's bigger. And then there's, in the records, it seems like that it was even bigger. I think this right here is a big son bitch right here. You got antenna right there. Going up. Very Moorish looking. And look at these houses compared to it. Oh, Mr. Contractor built this right here. Yep, little stick frame building. That's Mr. Contractor's house right there. He can build that. And we got December 1909, MetLife Building, Metropolitan Life Insurance Company Tower, on a gray winter afternoon in Manhattan, the year of its completion. It was the tallest building in the world until 1913, when it was surpassed by the Woolworth Building. That's a big son of a bitch right there too. Big old cupola. It's probably a wind catching system with these portholes. They probably could access the portholes and they probably went to different parts of the building. Just an idea. tourist fields with the lions right there for Tartaria. Pyramids. There's those ball thingies. Three-story clocks. Look at that thing. There's four of them suckers. Big old archways. Got pavement light right here on the front of the building. That's all pavement light right there. There's an opening into the underground right there. That's all pavement light in front of that building right there. Hippodrome. And there is a cupola. That looks like something out of Rome right there. Like the, was it the Pantheon? Big old columns with toruses on them. There's Mudflood right there. There's more Mudflood right there. New York was a hell of a place. Smokestack's not a smokestack. Got ether antennas all over the top here. Got another one over here. Alright, let's move on. Let's see. Okay, this is New York, circa 1908, campus, College of City of New York. Okay, College of City of New York. That's a weird name. But that, man, this campus is incredible. Look at the, and what kind of architect would design a building like this and then landscape it like this? I mean, what kind of dope are you smoking? Puff, puff, pass, mother humper. Puff, puff, pass. You got to share. I mean, look at that. What are you thinking? Oh, look at these compared to that. And you know there's something back here. They obviously, they've hidden it right here. Obviously, this stuff is later additions. They've come up with this crap. All this is our messing right here. If it looks like horse shit, we built it. It's real simple. Speaking of horseshit, there's Fred. Fred is supersonic right now, trying to get between job sites. Got a big old arch right here. I mean, look at the size of this archway right here. This door, these little tiny midget people, that's us. And look at the size of this winter. And then look how far these winters are in the ground. All that's in the ground right there. Seriously, look at the detail of those buildings. Incredible. Amazing. That is beautiful. Big old water tower. Another ether antenna there. Look at that thing. My goodness. That's got to have some wind catchers in it. Ether antenna back there. And they're doing some hiding right here. Looks like they're maybe laying brick roading. So we need to count on that brick right there. All that brick road right there. Gosh, that's incredible. And I was watching a show doing some research the other day called, it's on Netflix, called Dear White People. And it's, you know, straight up propaganda, but it, whoever the writers are, they're definitely aware of what's going on in our world, because they talk about all kinds of conspiracies that are going on in our world. And they drop all kinds of names and talk about things they probably shouldn't. But anyways, it focuses on this fictional college campus called, I think it's Winchester University. And it's supposed to be in, I think, Minnesota, but it's really filmed in reality. The filming location is the university, is UCLA. And it is straight up Tartarian style buildings. And it's, you look into it, and it's an old school. The campus is old. So the campus of UCLA needs to be researched. So, yeah, I mean, I never thought that UCLA would be, you know, old world, but it seems to be. Okay, let's move on. And we got another picture, same campus, New York, College of City of New York. We've got some ghost fellas, got a diamond symbology here. And look at this thing. I guess it's a flagpole. You have to wonder if that's an ether antenna. I don't know. And he's got these weird lights. I mean, look at the detail of these buildings. I mean, look at the got mudflood windows here and here. I mean, this is incredible architecture. Looks like something was removed there. Maybe, I don't know. They changed it. I don't know. They changed this matrix so much, it's so difficult to know what was really here. Look at these lights. I mean, they're just a trip. This guy's over here working on them. Got a ladder lean. Arch windows. Got winders below ground right there. That's a trip. All right, we got October 15th, 1912, White House Hotel, the building at 156 Canal Street, New York, where John F. Schrank lived prior to his attempted assassination of Teddy Roosevelt the day before. Okay, all right, odd. Got something underground right there, access right there. That right there is a telltale sign for underground. When you see these platforms that are built in front of the buildings, that's a way that they leveled in front of the stores so they could put things in front of the stores, because the sidewalks were not even, they weren't level. So anytime you see those, that's a telltale sign. That could be a sign right there of the underground right there. That looks like it's got a drop in right there. You got a fire hydrant. I believe fire hydrants are old world. Just me thinking. And that is so weird. Right there, you got an old saloon door, like a Western style saloon door. And you know, you see them in movies, all the time, but have you think about this for a second? Have you ever seen I can't say I've ever seen, other than right here in this picture, an actual saloon door on a building, on a door, actually not in a movie, in actual real life is what I'm saying. Now maybe it's more common than I know, but you know, it's just interesting. That right there, that little bit right there, that could be a door that's opened up to go down into an underground right here, but it's hard to tell. That's boss man right there. Those little arch windows. You got your eagle up here representing the phoenix. Got your ether finials and your ether fencing. Got laurel leaf control. These things I could be, I believe, are some sort of technology here. Heard they could be capacitors. The White House. Well, that's odd. Got you a star of your as above, so below pyramid there. Or Star of David. Has other meanings too, but just point it out. Underwear, light loft to let. Okay. Look at the cornice up here. I mean, what's the purpose of that on that building? Does that make sense? I don't think so. That's your torus right here, keystone, arch windows. Look at that cornice up there. All right, moving on. And we got Detroit, Michigan, 1900, W.H. Jackson residence. Okie dokie. And we got, you know, crappy, dirty streets. Big old stone facade. Marlboro. That's a name you see a lot. Marlboro. It's interesting. I wonder what that Marlboro was in the old world, because it seems like they used it over and over again. I don't know. Got some faces up here. Laurel Leaf of Control. What else can we find? Taurus Field right there. Arched windows, lots more faces. Got your Tartarian lion with the laurel leaf of control. Yep, I said the tartar word. Oh my goodness, dip that in tartar sauce. How you like that? Look at that face. Ooh, that's creepy. That's creepy looking. Wonder if that's a lion too. That's weird. I don't know. Is that same face? They don't look the same. I don't know. That's weird looking. It's like they removed something here in that niche. I don't know. That could be a window. No, I think that's a window. That's a window. Looks like a niche though. Weird. More torsos right here. All that brick. Get a brick count there. Gotta get all this brick counted up now. Somebody's building all this brick. Somebody's manufacturing all this brick. I don't think it was us. At the fencing. You know, yeah, I highly suggest doing a deep dive into research on the manufacturing of bricks in the, you know, 19th century, because you're going to find out which way's up. Because making bricks was hard. It ain't like today. It ain't automated. Won't back then. And it got mudflood winter right there, mudflood winter right there, mudflood winter right there, arched winders, more arched winders. But I mean, you know, it's a look into how hard it was to really look into how hard it was to make bricks. I'm serious. Really look into it. Don't just do a preliminary search. I'm talking about watch some damn long ass videos about brick making. And I'm talking about hours long videos of how they got to make bricks. You need to understand. This is Detroit, Michigan, 1910 Wayne County building. I'm just going to keep rambling. You need to understand how freaking difficult it was to manufacture bricks back then. And then once you got that in that understanding under your belt, go and look into the capabilities of the manufacturing facilities that were supposedly around in these time periods when these buildings are built. And then you cross-reference it by the buildings that were actually built in that town. And then you find out, for a lot of these buildings, you can find out how many bricks were used. And a lot of times you'll find that the manufacturing capabilities and the amount of bricks used in just a few buildings, or sometimes a single building, exceeds what was available. Okay. But then you got to count up all these other little bits. Okay. Here's an example. We're looking at this right here. Okay. This is this Detroit, Michigan, 1910 Wayne County building. I already said that, but now you know it twice. Look, you got this building right here. Okay. And you get up under this skirt right here, and you're going to find that there's probably brick under there. More than likely. Okay? So, let's just assume that's brick underneath there. Okay? So, you got to count up that other big... And they'll go, oh, well, we use a billion bricks on this building. Okay, whatever. A million bricks, 2 million bricks, 3 million bricks, whatever. Okay? Who cares? Doesn't matter. But then you also have to count all the bricks in this building. And this building, 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 and that building, and that building right there, and that chimney, okay? And you gotta get over here. You gotta go to this building. You gotta go to that building. Okay, you gotta get all these buildings. You gotta get this big old thing back here. You gotta get this building. You gotta get that one. Okay, you gotta get all these buildings. Oh, wait, wait. And then you gotta get the roads. Okay, because they're gonna build roads out of bricks a lot of times. You gotta check for walls. Okay, see all that wall? That's got brick in it. Okay, check for wall. You know, you gotta get the brick count for the walls. Okay, I don't know if that's brick wall or not, but you gotta look for walls because there's a lot of walls. Okay. Then you got to look for those tiles that are made of brick. Okay. My point is that you can't just count one building and go, oh, yeah, we got the capabilities to make that brick that time frame. No. You know, you look into this and you're going to find out that all this brick supposedly was made in the same era, the same time frame. Okay. Who made all that brick? Who? Who? You can't tell me. Mr. Contractor. Come on, Mr. Contractor. Tell me. Tell me something. That could be pavement light right there. See that line right there? That dark line? That could be pavement light. I can't prove it. And there's Fred. Fred is the horse that built America. I'm telling you. Tell you right now. The arch winners back there. Lottie dotty da 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 da. Smokestack, thank smokestack. I mean, look at this horse shit. Does that make sense? Think about that. What's under there? Does that make sense? I mean, look how stupid that looks. That's our horse shit. We did that. We built that, and we slapped a cannon outside. Yeah, that makes sense. And see that right there? See that? That's a telltale sign of Mudflood right there. Okay, that's a grate. Okay, that's covering over a window that's below ground level. Okay, go up there and get out there and get your magnifying glass out and look under there. You're going to find a window down there. Okay. All these horses running around. There's a horse and cart people built that shit. Okay. And I know it, like, you think about it, like, it's like, well, Rome did that. No, they didn't. That's the whole point. We didn't build none of this shit. All around the world, we didn't build this shit. We have been fed a bunch of horse manuki. And we swallowed it hook, line, and sinker. Because we're pretty dumb. But we waking up. We're pulling our heads out of our keisters. We're getting, you know, our act together now, okay? Even us awake folk, okay? We spent a long time, you know, learning about New World Order. It's gonna be New World Order. We gotta learn all about that bullshit, okay? We panted every time we heard some kind of new conspiracy, okay? We're past that now, okay? We're on to the bigger, better things. They got something going on right there. And look at this horse shit. You see them steps? That's horse shit. Does that look right? Think about that. Use your mind. Okay, that thing, that little peanut between your ears. Okay, use that and then think about that. And all of a sudden you'd be like, damn, I'm smart. That shit don't make sense. Or not. And then go back to sleep. I can't help you. No one can be told what the mud flood is. You have to see it for yourself. And what I'm trying to do here, in the best of my abilities, with the limited resources that I have, is to show you that there ain't no damn way in hell that Detroit, Michigan built that. You think about that. Detroit. Detroit Rock City. Hey, look at that. That's a wind catcher. That's Taurus. Why is Detroit building stuff like this? Think about that. It's a wind catcher. That cupola up there. And I'm not, I know that there's a big contingency out there that thinks that these were, you know, docks for the dirigibles. I'm not real big on that theory, And I'm not saying they didn't try it. I think they might have tried it. I think that might have been us that tried that. I got this feeling that that was not real safe. I mean, I just can't imagine aiming a dirigible, a device, a machine, or whatever you want to call it, an airship, whatever, and aiming it at the top of a building, and then mooring it to it, and then it's moving around, and then the wind, and I have a big, I'm not on board with that theory, I don't think. Not that those are little mini obelisks right there. Yep, scrubbed cartouches, more scrubbed cartouches. Look at that. And this is supposed to be built by us. Why would we ever have, you know, the thought that we built that? Because your grandma told you so? Because your pappy told you so? Because his pappy told him so? You know, you know, you go far enough back, and either one or two things happened. I'll tell you like it is. Or one of three things. Either A, they lied. I mean, straightforward. Okay. Or B, they were, I'm trying to think of where I'm going with this. Okay, either they lied that they, you know, they knew, and that they said, oh yeah, we built these buildings, knowing they didn't. Okay. Or they were brought into these cities, dropped into them. They were, you know, brought in from the outside and told that we built them, and they told each other the lie, and then they just perpetuated the lie. Or they were mind wiped. I'm talking about Men in Black style. Look here. Look in this little silver device, and it ping, and you know, your mind wiped. Now that sounds a bit far fetched. Until you know, really dig into the, you know, other conspiracies around our world. And I mean, who the hell knows? Who the hell say they don't have, that they didn't have or don't still have the ability to mind wipe? I mean, come on. You know, they put it in movies for a reason. The Fantastic Beast, they did the same thing in the movie Fantastic Beast. They mind wiped them. It's just something to think about. Look, we know we didn't build these buildings. So either they lied to us, our ancestors, okay? They lied to our families and they perpetuated the story, the lie, okay? And then the lie just kept going. Or they were brought into these cities, they were told this lie, and they had no reason to question it because, well, you know, you come in from off a boat and you're dropped into Detroit, you know? And they say, we built this. Who the hell are you to question that? Well, okay, it's here. We must have built it. You would never question it. And then you would just perpetuate the lie because, well, you were lied to. Or they were mind wiped. Detroit, Michigan, 1915. Partridge Building and Blackwell Department Store, P&B. Peanut butter jelly time. Peanut butter jelly time. I don't know where I got that from. Okay. And what we got here? Anyways. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Give me something interesting to look at. Because that is pavement light right there. Right there. 100% guaranteed. Woman in uniform. Old world fire hydrant right there. Ooh, pavement light. That's all pavement light right there. See all right there? It's all pavement light. Pavement light is evidence from mudflood. These are all transom glass, prism glass. They would shoot light back in the building just like the pavement light. Yep, I want to check something. Yeah, I'm just saying. Yep, Fred's right there. That's Fred. Fred's the horse that built America, in case you didn't know. Had a little help from the railroad tracks. That's true. That's true. That's not the point, though. So let's please not, you know, get off the point. Look at that brick. Got to crown all them little bricks. Every one of them little bricks counts. Every tiny little brick. Got to have a count on every one of them. Phoenician wave, scrubbed cartouche. That is incredible. This is not done by just everyday Joe Blow bricklayer. Kiss my ass. That's part of a wind catcher system right there. See how that glass opens right there? That, look, man, who's cutting that glass? Seriously? Look at that. It's got a curved here and a curve. It's got two curves in each pane of glass. That's crazy. Yet, porthole there. Wow. Mama mia. That is something else. Look at that. Laurel leaf. That looks Phoenician. There's the Phoenician lady. Phoenician shell. Very Phoenician building. That thing is just dripping. Dripping, dripping, dripping. That is crazy. Got an antenna up there. Wonder if there's mercury in the ball. I don't know. Just wondering. Flat Earth asterisk. That's the symbol for flat Earth. It's got your vertical representing the north and south magnetic poles, and your flat plane of the flat Earth, and your X representing the torus. So that is the symbol, I believe, in my opinion. My humble opinion is that that is the symbol for the flat Earth. That is them telling you it ain't a globe, people. And while you're at it, get your drone and fly it up in the air and then land it down about an hour later and tell me where that drone lands. Remember, we're supposed to be spinning on a ball at, you know, 26,000 some odd miles an hour. Okay, so you tell me where that drone's gonna land. You take a drone, fly it straight up in the air, let it hover for 1 hour, drop it down in exactly straight down. Okay, where should it land? Okay, if you start, let's say you're in New York, okay, and you fly this drone straight up in the air, you let it hover for 1 hour, or a helicopter, anything that will hover. Okay, and you let it hover for 1 hour. Okay, where's it going to land when you drop it back down? Think about that. And I know the simple answer, it's going to land right there where I took off at. Will it? Well, the answer is yes, obviously. Come on, people. Obviously, the answer is yes. That's a coal hole cover right there, and that's pavement light. But that's not the point. The point is, by the theory of it being a globe, is that it would not land exactly where it took off. They say it would, you know, if you're traveling at 26,000 miles an hour, that thing should be a long damn ways away. Think about that. Use your noggin. Look at that transom glass. Use your noggin on that. Put two and two together and add up that and see what you come up with. And don't give me all the hoo-shoes about there's all this stuff in the atmosphere, and it moves around, blah, blah, and moves with the blah, blah, blah. Horse shit. Quit making shit up. Bill Nye, a science guy. I mean, these people are idiots. Okay, they're laughing at you. Okay, use your damn heads, people. Think about a flight from New York to L.A. and how long it takes, and then take a look at how long it takes a flight to go from LA to New York. Okay? Think about the times of how long it takes. Think about that. one way it should be shorter than the other by a lot. Think about that. Go look into that. That's a porthole. Old after light right there. Look into that. Another porthole right there. We got to start thinking, you know, with our heads. Oh, look at that beauty. My, oh my. Look at that antenna back there. Probably a wind catcher there. I really love this concept of the wind catcher. It really, I highly suggest going to look up wind catchers and getting to understand those, because that's coal hole cover. Because lady in uniform, that's Bossman right there. Yeah, I think it's a very interesting piece of our evidence. Main Street, Buffalo, New York in 1900. And we got dude crossing the street. And we got a people catcher. Court, Niagara, 14th, Utica. Okay. Ladies in uniform. Is that a cigar store Indian? That's wild looking. There's a clock. Clocks are expensive. We got arched windows. Iroquois. Ether antenna. Ether finials with the ball type. Look at these lights up here. Old ether lights. Ether finial. See, we see this right here. It looks so simple. That's technology. That was the beauty of the old world. Their simplicity was high tech. They were freaking geniuses compared to us. Pence Cat Boss Man right there talking to Boss Man. Just saying. There's Fred. Fred's the horse that built America. In case you were unaware, now you are aware. Now you have been led to the water. And there is some arched windows. Look at all that ether technology right there. Arc lighting. Boater hats. If you get bored, won't go down a funny little rabbit hole. Boater hats have a little interesting history. That's a boater hat right there. They were a popular for a while, and it, what's interesting is, you know, why they're not popular anymore. Look into that. If you want an interesting little rabbit hole of, you know, early 19th century, or 19th century history, earliest 20th century history, and right around there, around the turn of the century, the history is interesting on that one damn hat. It's just so weird. Boater hats. That's an interesting picture. Sign company. Okay. Got some weirdness right there. That's strange. Look at those weird stairs going up right there. Look how weird that is. That's just strange. I don't know. That's odd to me. Let's see. Established 1867. Ether antenna. All right. Let's see what else we got. Oh, it's a nice little picture. 1909, New Haven, Connecticut. 12-year-old newsboy. Hyman Alpert. Oh, poor little fella. Why would you name your child that? Oh, my God. Been selling 3 years, spends evenings in boys club. Newsies are their history is so interesting. These old pictures of these newsboys are always interesting. They always have the greatest character to them. I guess they had to be to sell them papers. They had to sell them, you know, and sell themselves. But the reason I'm showing you this picture is a reason. Okay. You got ventilation underground right there, and you got ventilation underground there. But this is what I want to show you is this grate. Okay. Now that grate doesn't look all that interesting or important, but it is. It's hugely important. This is the precursor to pavement light. Okay. This is what they had all over the place. This was the original fix for the windows and doors below ground, was to put these iron grates over the holes in order to let the sunlight in. The problem was that people would drop things in there and the ladies' heels would get stuck in there and they'd hurt themselves. They're ridiculous, not to mention that the water ran right into them. So these are the precursor to pavement light. That's a little history for you. And this is interesting. New and rare books. I mean, you imagine what's in those books right there? You just drop me off there. I'll go reading. Got no problem with that. I'll go read that. Memphis, Tennessee, circa 1910, Hotel Gayoso. Okay. What a name for a store. And we got Fred. Fred is the horse that built America right here. Let's see, we got pavement light right here. Y'all think I'm joking about this pavement light? I'm gonna keep saying it because I'm telling you that pavement light is important. See, we don't see it today. It don't make sense. But see, they removed it. They got rid of it. It was everywhere. It was in the big cities, the small towns. It was everywhere. I have found it all over the place. Incredible stuff. Incredible history. Just right there could be pavement light. Hard to tell. That's another thing is the pavement light. They used it in all kinds of places. I mean, when you look in the pavement light, you'll find out that they installed it all over the damn place. Inside, outside, they had stored. They would put it on like they would put it in roofs. They all kinds of ways, but one really popular way was to put it inside the entrances, so as you walked in the store that there was light coming, you know, in there. But I suggest I don't know what number it is. I want to say episode 33, 32, or 31. I can't remember which. Go to Streets of Tartaria channel and watch. It's one of his latest videos, and he goes under into a basement, and I want to say it's in Logan, and I forget what state that is, but he goes in and he's in this basement and he's looking around and what it is, he did a video there. And when he got, I guess later on, he looked back at the video, and I saw it in the video when he first did it, but there was pavement light there and he didn't notice it. I guess he wasn't as aware to pavement light as he is now, but anyways, he missed it somehow. And, I remember seeing it when he did it, but long story short, he goes back and he gets down in the basement and he goes and he's talking to his contractor who's down there in the basement. And you got to go watch this video because it's pure Mudflood research gold. Okay. He's down there talking to his contractor and he's asking the contractor, you know, he's looking at the pavement light underneath the building, the front of the building. He's up under here, right? And he's looking up at the pavement light. Okay, and they're talking about, and basically he's standing in a Mudflood building, and he's like asking the contractor, so what do you think happened here? And the guy just lays it out. It was Mudflood. I mean, he didn't know that Caleb was a Mudflooder, and he didn't. I don't even think I didn't even get the gist that he was saying that he believed it was he believed in Mudflood theory as much as he was saying the mud came in and covered it up. Like it was like he I may be wrong, but it sounded kind of like he was either saying either A, it was mud flooded because he's a mud flooder, or he was saying it was mud flooded and it was like blatantly obvious it's been mud flooded. It was such as go check it out. It's either 31, it's either episode 31, 32, or 33. Watch all his episodes. Just do that. But all those are really good. But there's that one. You got to go check that out. That's Mudflood Gold. I'm telling you, that's Mudflood Gold. Got to go check it out. Okay, enough rambling. That looks Celtic. I can ramble now. Don't get me wrong. Look at this symbology here. Look at this Moorish business here. Oh, turrets. Look at this little bit right here. You got the dripping fruit. That's always interesting. Looks like a ether antenna. This is weird how it's squared off. Something looks like it was... I bet you a nickel they removed something from that building. I don't know. That's really red flag. I mean, you got pavement lights in front of this thing. That's pavement light right there. In case you didn't know what pavement light is, that's it. You got transoms with the prism glass in it. See, Gayoso. That's the name of the hotel. You believe it or not. You got more pavement light right there. Scrub cartouches. Arched windows. Jewelry and optical goods. Look at that. Oh, man. Look at that. Ooh. Oh, look at that. Scrub cartouche. Wow, look at that symbology. What's going on with that? What does that mean? Oh. That is wild looking. I don't know what in the world that is. Ether antenna up there. Greater Memphis. Look at that. That's odd. It's got a barn door track covering up an arch window. So weird. Anyways, and I normally stick to the United States for these MUDDIN videos for now, at least. Who knows what the future brings? But this one just, when I was sifting through my mess, this one just stood out to me for some reason. Montreal. From the Church of Notre Dame, 1900. And my goodness, I mean, there's Fred. Let's just get Fred on the map here. That's Fred Horse Built America, you know, and other related Tartarian countries. And got some business there. Got tourist field there. Got portals there. Laurel leaf of control there. Scrubbed cartouche there. Portal. See that one's open. See that how that opens? That's part of the wind catcher system. Same here. See that's part of wind catching system. And there's different kinds of wind catchers. They have different ways of making them. So you can't look at one and go, oh, that's a wind catcher. Oh, this is a wind catcher. And I put a GIF in the... I don't know if I mentioned this or not. Put a GIF in the end of the video, this video, that is showing how the wind catchers work, so you'll have a better idea in case you're too lazy to go do your own research. I'll show you some of mine. How you like them apples? I just called you lazy. I'm telling you, get off your ass and go do some research is what I'm telling you. You got to think for yourself, and I'm trying to give you the ability to do that, because I understand how hard it is to think when you're not. They have trained us in our dumbed down educational system to be, you know, morons, literally. I mean, and I know that's a harsh way to say it, but they literally had us at moron level. And so we have to rise above. I mean, what's going on here? I don't even know. It looks like an Indian fella, another Indian fella. So I don't know what in the world that is. As above, so below. I don't know. Hell, I know what's going on there. Hard to tell. Phoenician shell. No, we got the smokestacks. It ain't smokestacks. Another wind catching system there. Look way up on that hill there. Look at that thing. Good grief. That's a castle. Jeez. A big old place here. There's a lot of brick. We need a brick count on this. Good grief, let's put clocks up there. You got to wonder if them clocks were there. You know? See, I think time, this horseshit time that they've always got us, you know, running on the mouse wheel about. I think we came up with that shit after the mud flood. I think they that the whole time business is a whole new invention. I think we came up with that in some way, shape, or form. I got this my hunch that my spidey senses is up that time ain't what we thought. That they came up with it as a way to control us. To keep us on a mouse wheel. Got you a rose window right there. There's that three symbol right there. Ether finials, ether fencing, ether antennas. Look at that ether fencing in it. Woof, man. Portals right there. Excuse me, portals. The two utes. What's a ute? Excuse me, youths. If you've never seen My Cousin Vinny, you ain't seen it. You ain't seen nothing. You got to go see that. That identical. You got to go see My Cousin Vinny if you ain't seen that movie. That's a funny movie. Oh man, I'm sorry, I get sidetracked. Let's see. Look at them arch winners and toruses. There's them ball thingies. Jeez. There's Boss Man right there. Hanging out. There's another clock. Got you some mudflood winters down here in case you want to see some mudflood. Got a coal hole covered right there. Another mudflood winters right there. Just incredible. Man. We're so primitive compared to this people. Not the people in, not these people. I'm not talking about these people. These people are primitive. I'm talking about the person, the people, the folk that built that door right there. I'm talking about the large people, the big people, the giants, man. I said it, the giants. Go watch my video, Little People Giants World. I made that. Go check that out. I made that to show my whole concept behind that video. That's a badass video. And that video's got, I think that video over time, not just on my channel, but because it was on Michelle Gibson's channel for a long time, and now it's off there so that I can get the view count up on mine. But if you add up what I got, which is like 15,000, and you add up what she had when she took it off, I think it was at like 70,000. So that is about it could be somewhere between 80 and 85,000 views on that video. That's a big video. I'm proud of that. I mean that says something because my whole idea behind that video was to submerse the viewer in what the world was like before they took out the giants. Like what would it be like if they were in our world? And it I wanted to explore that idea. And that's really what that video is about, is exploring what it was like, what it could be like, what they took out, and to see our world in a from a different perspective and see how little we are compared to what it really was. This is New Orleans, 1906, old absinthe house and bar. And if you don't know what absinthe is, it is a they call it the green fairy. It's a liquor that it'll bait you basically trip balls. You'll hallucinate your ass off. And it's very popular in like Europe and stuff. It's illegal in the States. I think they're bringing it back now, but it's not like what they're bringing in now is not it's knockoff shit. It's crap. But the real deal stuff is it'll you'll blast off to the imaginary moon. You'll call it the green fairy for nothing. But anyways, I just thought this was interesting to look into a an old world saloon bar or whatever you want to call it, and kind of see how they lived high on a hog. Look at that ceiling fan, the decoration just on a ceiling fan, and this old world possibly radiator stove. That is really high tech looking. I mean, I use a wood stove, y'all. Okay, that's what I get my heat from. I love the wood stove. It is a wonderful heat. It takes a lot of getting used to and how to use it properly. Took me a long time to really work out the kinks of how to control it, in a way that was, really comfortable. But now that I've got it, under my belt, it is really nice. But that's not a wood heater, from my knowledge. This is New York, 1903, Steeplechase Park, Coney Island, and this shot's kind of interesting because it's kind of a behind the scene. It's not behind the scenes, but it's kind of more behind the scenes than most of the Coney Island shots that you see. So it's kind of cool. That's probably Boss Man right there. And I just don't even know what to tell you about that. Yep. So, and we got cows. He's smoking a joint. Good for you, my boy. Women in uniform. Okay. This thing right here is crazy. I actually have film of this somewhere. The Razzle Dazzle. And this sucker, this is a ride, y'all. Okay. See, I've got this pole here in the center. And they got this round thing here. Okay, you can't see the whole thing, but this thing's completely round. It's held by these cables. And if you ain't never seen this thing in action or pictures, search Razzle Dazzle, Coney Island. But what you did was you got up on this thing and you sat on the edge here, okay? Sat up on that sucker right there, and this sucker went around and around. It turned around and around while you're just sitting up on the edge of that thing. Now you think about how many people got hurt doing that. Think about that. And they had some rides that back then. One of these days, I plan on getting into some of these rides they had going on. They had some deadly ass rides. I'm not joking. Some of these things were massively freaking dangerous. I can't even imagine that anybody would ever get on them, but these people, oh my God. Wait, what's that say? Nails skin like a baby's babe skin soap. What the hell are y'all selling? I don't even know. I don't know what that is. It's a cupola up here. Got their antennas. Homeboy's changing out the Phoenix, looks like. Phoenix on a Taurus on a ball. That's what that is. Horses up here. Statues of Fred. That's your wind turbine there. I don't think the rest of this is too wonderful, but we'll look anyways just for, you know, giggles. It's, like I said, it's behind the scenes, so it's kind of ain't a whole lot to see. It's interesting, though. New York, 1904, Easter crowds on Fifth Avenue. Easter crowds. So, this is the show to say, hey, look at me. God is impressed with me. Hey, top hat dude, go fuck yourself. Excuse my French people. I just got no patience for elitists. None. You too. Especially you, fat ass. Not degrading fat people. Some people is fat. But some people is fat in a way that's not cool. They're fat with pockets that are deep. I'm going to tell you right now. This past week, I saw a box come from a food bank to a family. And they had, in the box, there was a box. And now this is, they get one box. They gave a family one box. Just imagine a box, just a box that you could carry, right? Okay, you get home with your box and you sit down. You go start going through your box, okay? And in your box, you got a box. And then this box is, let's say the box was approximately 18 inches long by 8 inches high by 12 inches wide, okay? Not a very big box. And in this box supposedly contains food for 5 days for a K through 12 student for breakfast and lunch. And they had it all worked out how you prepare these meals and all this and all that. But you have never seen such crap horseshit nourishment in your entire life that they are passing off for food for the underprivileged in America. We should be ashamed of ourselves for what we're, you know, allowing to be done to help the underprivileged in our world. If you got enough money to feed yourself and you got extra, go help a family that's in need in some way, shape, or form. Quit buying, you know, shit you don't need. There's people out there that right now, this box, I mean, man, I'm going to tell you right now, I'm a big boy. I'd eat that whole damn box if I wanted to in one sitting, okay? I'm a big boy, but imagine an 18-year-old boy that's trying to eat this sorry-ass box of food as his nourishment for 5 days. It's not even 7 days, for 5 days. I mean, you got to be shitting me. You top hat son of bitches. Okay? If you got more than you need, okay, and you know who you are and you know what you got, and I don't think most people watching this video have a whole lot extra, and that's okay. I ain't talking to you. You know who I'm talking to. And the ones of you that do have, you know what I'm saying. There's Fred. Fred's the horse that built America. Some days he goes to Easter services and takes assholes like this to go act like they give a damn about God. Okay, these people don't give... Do these people look like they give a damn about God? No. This is a fucking fashion show. Okay, that's what this is. This ain't got nothing to do with God. God don't give a damn what your bowler hat looks like, or your top hat, or your fancy coats, and your fancy-ass hats. You see that right there? Lady, go fuck yourself. Excuse my French. I'm speaking French today. I'm sorry, I'm rambling. I've had a rough. I've had my head so far up a computer's ass this past week. You just don't even know. I'm trying to make things better, but it has been trying. Windows, Bill Gates, go fuck yourself. Excuse my French. I ain't. How the hell are you gonna? How the hell are you gonna sell a computer that works perfectly, except for the fact that randomly, no matter what program you're using, and in no particular time, shape, rate, it'll just freeze, and literally you have to do a hard reboot, which means you have to hit the power button and totally power down in order to power back up to get back control of your computer. And there's literally no go around. And I have been programming computers since I was in fourth freaking grade. Okay. I have spilt coffees, entire large Starbucks coffees on a laptop before, took it apart, cleaned it piece by piece with a freaking Q-tip. Okay. Put it back together and made it work. Okay. I know computers. Okay. I'm no IT specialist, but I know a damn computer. Tartarian lion. Okay. I know how to work with computers, and I pulled out every trick known to man and then some. Okay? And I could not get this computer fixed. I tried changing all kinds of settings. I researched. I changed things. I put programs on. I put programs off. I killed the operating system. I did everything. I rebuilt the operating system. I did everything. I tried Windows 10, Windows 10 Pro, Windows 10, Winprint, Windows 11. Okay? None of that shit worked. Okay. My point is, I was doing my best to try to make this thing work, and I could not get it to go. So, anywho, look at the size of these little tiny people compared to that. Why in the world would they think that is how they would build that? Etherlights. Come on, y'all. Why would we think we built that? Our head's so big that we think we built rose windows. That's sacred geometry. We can't even do common core math or whatever the hell it's called. New math. What's that math they're teaching these people today? I swear you people can't count. The people can't count these days. You say, what's 1 + 1? They go, let me get my calculator. It's on my smartphone. Jeez. And look at that. Really, you think we built that? Seriously? Look at the scale. Look at the scale. That dog don't hunt. I don't care how you look at it. I don't care if you could build this. I don't care if you had all the materials, you had all the skilled craftsmen. I don't care if, if you had all the money in the damn world, which obviously these people do. But I don't care about all that. There's absolutely no reason you would build this building to look like that in this time frame. It's impossible. It just wouldn't happen. These people, the only thing they care about is a dollar, okay? This dude right here would give you the best freaking. He would do very naughty things to you if you would give him a dollar. That's all I'm gonna say. He'd do anything for a dollar, okay? That's all these people understand, the dollar. This guy, he working for a dollar, okay? That's working man, okay? Okay. All right, this son bitch right here, this son bitch right here, this fairy ass fuck right here, okay, this one right here, he'd lick your toes for a dollar. Excuse my French. I got to move on. And we've got 1910, Ralph E. Madison, the tall cowboy, shaking hands with Senator Morris Shepherd at the Capitol. And I don't really care how you look at it. That dude right there is a giant. Okay? I believe that these old, like the in this time frame, this the 1900, you know, late 1800s. I believe these guys that were this tall, I believe they are descendants of the giants. They're like inbred. Look, this dude's, you know, daddy was a giant, and this dude's mama was this dude's size, right? And they got together, and they had a dude in between. Okay. I believe he is a crossbreed between a regular folk like us little midgets and a giant. And it made him taller, and they call it giantism. They say it's a defect. It's not a defect. It is a defect. Okay, I should say it is a defect. Okay, it is a defect between breeding a giant and a human our size. A human giant and a human midget size. We're midgets. Okay, we're not midget, midget, midget bit down here. There's your boater hat. That's boater hat. But I'm saying that this fella's mama and daddy were two different sizes. Okay, and when they had him, it created a genetic defect called what we call giantism. Okay, and that you know, he's descendant of giants. That's a tall son of a bitch right there. But anyways, this guy right here, he went around and hit. This was his gag. Okay. He would go around and be the cowboy, the tall cowboy, and he made, you know, appearances, and that's how he made money. And I put his ass in color. Hoorah! I know, I just thought that was cool. Anyways, moving on. New York, 1905, Broad Street Exchange and Curb Brokers. Now, that's just incredible, the scale of these tiny little people compared to this world. And there's Fred. Fred's the horse to build America. That's boss man right there. Look at this asshole. Junior asshole right there. That's junior asshole. He gonna smoke him a joint before he goes to work. There's Wilma. That's Fred's lady friend. Yep. Dine-in rooms. Just seeing what kind of horse shit we got going on down here. Oh, what are all y'all boater hats standing in the middle of the road for? That just don't make no sense. Well, y'all delivering chickens here? We got underground right here. Access to the underground right there. In case you need to go underground. More access to underground. Look at that. Got big old doors underground there. Phoenician wave right there. Arc light. Look at the size of that door. It's all about scale. There's the ether lights. It's all facaded here. Tartarian lions. Oh, put a dollar in the kitty, y'all. Tell you what, let's put a dollar in the kitty every time I say the word Tartaria or Tartarian or Tartary, okay? And then we'll donate it to some poor family that ain't got shit. How about that? Let's do that. Tartarian lion, right there. There's another dollar in the kitty. Another Tartarian lion, another dollar in the kitty. Come on now. We got people in the world that don't got nothing, y'all. Okay? And we're over here sucking down cheeseburgers like it's the you know, the end all and be all. Okay? You buy a cheeseburger, buy somebody else a cheeseburger. As you're driving down the road, you see somebody sitting on the side of the road. Okay, they ain't got shit. And you know they ain't got shit. Hand them that other cheeseburger. Do something. I mean, that buy them something better. Buy them some vegetables. That's Phoenician right there. Yep, that's Phoenician. Phoenician wave, laurel leaf. Oh, not laurel leaf. That's Phoenician. Scrub cartouche. There's that dripping fruit stuff, pyramid. No, I'm serious. I mean, you know, we got okay. Example. And I've always kind of been a stickler for this. This I'll tell you a story. It's story time. Story time with Beaks. Anyways, I'm in Atlanta, Georgia, and I'm walking down Peachtree Street. Okay, and I'm hanging out, you know, because I've, you know, done stuff like that. And this black guy walks up to me, and obviously he's a street dude. And a Phoenician shell. Look at all these, like, right here. And this guy walks up to me, and he says, hey, man, I make you a bet. I'm like, a bet? I'm like, what you bet? And he goes, come on, man, let me bet. He goes, I bet you that I can tell you where you got your shoes. And he said, I bet I can tell you what city you got your shoes in and what street you got them on. And I said, all right, that's a bet. And his fool says, you got them in Atlanta, Georgia on Peachtree Street. And he was right. My shoes was on in Atlanta, Georgia on Peachtree Street. And I thought that shit was so funny. But I said, you know what, dude? I'm going to be honest with you. I ain't going to give you no money. But what I'll do is I'll go down here to McDonald's and I'll buy you a meal. And I about went down there and bought him a meal. You see the difference? Because you know that fool going to go out there and buy him a beer. Or drugs. Something like that. Well, maybe not. Maybe he was going to buy something to eat. But you know what? I made sure he got something to eat. You know what? He was really appreciative of that. I don't know. That's one of my little Atlanta stories. I also got chased down Peachtree Street. Drunker than a skunk by the Atlanta Police Department. Because I stole one of their police cones. And they never caught me because I got into the hotel. That big hotel downtown. And I got up into my hotel room. They never caught me. But boy, they were hot trot to get their police cone back. They wanted that back for some reason. Of course, it started off me sliding down the, if you ever been rode the MARTA, the subway in Atlanta, you know about there's a big old, near Peachtree Street somewhere. I can't remember exactly where. Somewhere near Atlanta Underground. They have this big, gigantic, I don't even, 40... four-story, I don't even know, it's so long of an escalator that goes down, and it's like so tall. It's unbelievably tall. Well, I slid down that thing on the slidey part. And the law saw me do it. And so the law started chasing me, and as I'm running from the law, I grabbed their police cone because it was after the New Year's parade or whatever, so they had the police cones out, so they were in hot pursuit over their police cone in the wild, crazy Tartarian line. Just saying, put a dollar in key for each of those, give it to a poor family. You ain't got to send it to me, take it to a poor family, count up how many Tartarian lines I saw said right there, and then go give that amount some poor family that ain't got shit. Okay. We got to help people out in the world, okay? Please do. I mean, I'm not appreciative to quarter. I'll tell you what I did today. You know what I did today? I went today and I went to a thrift store and I found some silverware. And there's this family I know they ain't got what they need, and so I found them some silverware. I ain't pay a lot for it. It's a thrift store, but I got them some silverware. That's something I could do for them. Not that I ain't got shit, but you know, I did that for them because you know what we do for others comes back in some way, shape, or form. New York, circa 1905. Hotels Netherland and Savoy, 5th Avenue and East 58th. Wow. Holy moly. That's creepy. Okay, that's Boss Man going to work. Got the water, the street sprayed down here. Look at that right there. That's a ghost horse there. That's pretty cool. I think make sure we got him. There's Fred. Fred's right there. Got to make sure we find Fred. Everybody wants to know where Fred is. And there's Wilbur. Wilbur's his cousin. And we got pavement light right there. In case you need some of that. More of that. Got pavement light right there. You need a good close up. Oh, these are cool. Oh, those are cool. That's pavement light, but it's a trap door. So you got pavement light in a trap door. Right here and here. Haha, that's rare to see that. Those are coal hole covers right there. That's pavement light right there. We built these outcrop doors here. That's our way of covering up the horse shit that we took over. Laurel leaf of control right there. Look at the drippings on that building. Good grief. Man. Oh, wow. Look at that. I, you know, this research is so fascinating. Look at that is pavement. All that is pavement light. That's a good at 10 feet of pavement light right there. That's the man. That means that whole, look, y'all, this whole sidewalk is hollow. You know how I know that? I'm going to tell you how I know that. It's real simple. You got the telltale signs of pavement light here and coal hole covers here. Well, that coal hole, you open that up and it drops into what's called the vault or a vault. Okay. Now, I don't know why they call it a vault, but it's called a vault. Okay. That's the technical construction architectural term is called a vault. Okay. And they had arched ceilings a lot of times. But that is a vault. Look at that. Good gracious. Scrub cartouche. In friggin' incredible, man. That is phenomenal. Where do you even begin on that? I don't know. I don't know. Just come on, people. Who had the ability, the time, the money, the resources, the skilled labor, the materials, the laurel leaf of control, who had it to build this? That reminds me of the winged disc right there. Yes, I know it's not a winged disc. Hello, pyramid. That looks like a star fort right there. Don't that look like a star fort in a way? Just saying, kinda, I don't know. That's interesting. There's another one. That's got a very Star 40 look to it. I don't know. I don't know, it's kind of reminiscent of it. I can't tell for sure, but that could be a line right there. And you know what line represents? Tartaria, put a dollar to kitty. And just count up how many line, let's just say that's Tartarian lines. Let's just do a solid Tartarian lines across there. Do up all those Tartarian lines and say it yourself, and then put a dollar in a kitty for each one. And then take that down to some poor family that ain't got shit, don't, you know, need something, you know. And people don't just need money. People need food. People need clothes. People need rides, places. People need all kinds of things. You never know what people need until you ask them. Don't just assume that you can just throw a dollar bill at somebody and that's going to cure their problem. Sometimes they don't need a dollar. Sometimes there's something they need that they can't get for some reason. And you know, sometimes you just talk to them. Say, hey, yo, dude, is there anything you need? And it might be something simple. Might not be something simple, but for some folks, things are a little easier than others, and they can actually make that not so simple thing happen. I'm just trying to give you a better idea. We got to start. You know, got the old saying, I ain't my brother's keeper. Well, you kind of are, okay? You kind of are. If we don't look out for our fellow man, we're not looking out for ourselves, because we are one. And when we let people fall through the cracks, we fall through the cracks. Look at all that. Big old ether antenna up there. Porthole. Another porthole. Pyramid symbology. Arches. More pyramids. I mean, that's just sick. That is just incredible. What in the world? Who's got the goodies in their bank account to build that? Look at a shitty sign. Seriously. Look at oh my God. That is, oh my God. You know what that reminds me of? Okay, picture a Lamborghini. Okay, in your mind, okay? Or whatever fancy ass sports car you think is cool, okay? Just picture the baddest ass sports car you can imagine, right? Your dream sports car. If you had all the money in the world, you could buy whatever sports car you want. Imagine that sports car, okay, in your mind, okay? Now, in your mind, spray paint on the side of that car, Hotel Netherland. I mean, that's what they've done. They have graffitied an old world building. That's exactly what they've done. I mean, seriously, look at the hole in the ground there, y'all. Seriously, why would you do that? What kind of architectural dumbass would do this? Look at this. Look at this guy. He's like, who the hell built this shit, man? I gotta do this. Whatever I'm doing here, I gotta do this in such a stupid way. This is so stupid. Look at that. What the hell, man? I mean, you got to be smoking some peyote to be getting some. Look at that architecture. I mean, that is straight up tripping. Somebody was on shrooms building that. I'm serious. I mean, God. Oh, man. What the world? Look at that. Okay, we got a porthole behind a chimney. Huh. With a chimney on top of a chimney. Look at that. Look how they modified that. See the modification we did? See the horse shit we did right there, okay? You see that piece right there? That's our horse shit. This is the old wind catcher system here. And then we horse shitted it up. I'm sorry, Fred. I shouldn't talk about your back end like that. That's derogatory towards horses. Poor Fred. He just don't get no respect. Oh my gosh, I can't take it. Oh, come on, man. New York 1909 Hotel Astor Times Square. Yeah, this is just... Oh my goodness. Do y'all get it yet? Seriously? I mean, Fred is working so hard, you can't even hardly see him. And Boss Man's up his ass. And you got damn Mudflood, damn drop-ins right here. You just go right under the buildings. I mean, because that makes sense. I don't know, man. Seriously, who in the hell? Oh, God. Look. Wow. There's your Lamborghini. And there's your graffiti. Astor. Oh, my God. Astor. What a name. What an assholy name, Astor.
Yes, I'm Astor. I'm John Jacob Astor. Kiss my ass.
Got all the money in the world. Who cares? Flat Earth Asterix right there. In case you need that, got pavement light right there. Oh, my goodness. We made that right there. That's our horse shit right there. Those little outcrop door thingy dobbers. Okay. Astor Theater. I'm an asshole tour. New York Hippodrome. Woohoo! And we got the ether antennas up here and up here. Thermos the bottle. Oh my gosh. This is just comical at this point. I mean, if you believe that we built this shit, I can't help you. And nobody can help you. You just might as well go to Walmart and walk around. Because you're done. Oh, that's a scrub cartouche. Portholes. See how they're opening up? So that's an oval porthole. That's interesting. Oval porthole. Scrub cartouche. Phoenician waves. Oh my god. I mean, come on. Seriously? Portholes? Portholes. Portholes everywhere. Portholes. Ether antennas. Ether lights everywhere. Oh, this thing is just stupid. Phoenician shells. My god. Seriously? Come on. This is just no way. I'm going to put some trees on the roof. Why not? Who cares? Nobody's going to believe shit anyways. Oh my god. Oh, shit. Look at that. You know, you have to wonder I would love to be a fly on the wall for a rich family's conversation with their, you know, progeny, with their youngins when they're coming up and saying, look, okay, here's how big assholes we are. We didn't build this world. We stole it all. Okay. And it's going to be your job to hide it from the world. Hey, can you imagine those poor kids? Then they're like, wait, what? Papa, what are you talking about? you flooded the world with mud and you stole all the buildings. Daddy, what are you talking about? Son, it's our responsibility to hide this from the public. We got these things called pavement lights. And we're going to cover it up. They ain't going to know shit. We're going to dumb down through their education and their aspartame. And we're going to put Phoenician waves all over everything in shells. Oh my god. It's going to be comical. These people, they're going to believe anything we tell them. As long as we give, you know, make sure that they have some bread and circuses. And, you know, they got some beer and some Tartarian lines, put a dollar in the kitty. Tartarian lines, put a dollar in the kitty. And Tartarian line, put a dollar in the kitty. We're going to feed some poor tonight, I'm telling you right now. And then you got mud flood all down through there. And you got the horse shit. Oh, those are brown stones. Yeah, okay. Whatever. Yep. Yep. Yep, 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 yep. Okay, I can't take anymore. It's too much. It's too much. Oh, but come on, man. You got to be shitting me. New York, 1910, Union Square. The MetLife Tower presides over this panoramic view. Come on, man. Seriously. Pavement light, pavement light, pavement light. Look at the size of that door. Look at that little sucker right there. That's a big son bitch right there. Look at that fella. Now that ain't no little fella. Oh, dude, look at that fella. Huh. Look at that fella compared to that fella. Ooh, that might be giant. I don't know. That probably wasn't like that guy, that cowboy, that cat. He's probably like that. Oh, man, got a griffin. There's a griffin. That is Tartaria right there. Griffin. That's red flag Tartaria right there. Yep. More pavement light. Look at the scale from these little suckers right here to that sucker right there. I mean, come on. Freaking incredible. Pavement light all over the front. Ladies in uniform. Pavement light, pavement light, pavement light. Look at that horse shit right there. There's underground right there. It's everywhere. This place is off the hook. Fred's on the job. Fred's the horse that built America. That's Boss Man right there. Got more pavement light, pavement light, pavement light, pavement light. I tell you what, back then, if you was in the pavement light business, you was rich. Because they used a lot of that stuff. More pavement light right there with a raised platform. Tourist field there. More pavement light right there. Okay, good grief. I mean, come on. Seriously, this world. Okay. Lion, 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 lion. Tartaria, 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 Tartaria. Tartaria, 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 Tartaria. Okay. Oh gosh, more Tartarian lines. Why are lions on buildings in America?
Well, that's for the British Crown.
No, it ain't for British Crown, man. Hell, it's not even the lion doesn't even represent the British Crown in Britain. It's all horse shit. It's all cover up, y'all. They had to come up with these stories to keep us dumbed down and believing their lie. I don't know why they did this. They're crazy people. They're cuckoo clocks. Y'all do realize that we wrote that on that building after we stole it. That is graffiti, is what that is. That is Lamborghini graffiti. You know what this reminds me of? Have you ever watched the movie? The show. What was it called? Bam Margera. Bam. That show, what the hell, that show where the Bam Margera show, whatever that show was that he did where he would film from his house. If you ever saw that, back when I was asleep, I admit I'd watch crap swill like that. Don't watch it anymore, but I did back then because it went great with a beer. But the point is that he did a show where he goes to pick up Billy Idol, and he's going to take him, he picks him up from the airport, and he's going to take him to his concert, and on the halfway on the way, they stop on the side of the road, and he's driving a Lamborghini, and they stop on the side of the road, and Billy Idol's talking about how he wants to get some sun, so he has one of his boys bring out a cordless reciprocating saw, and on the side of the highway, they cut the roof off his Lamborghini. That's what this reminds me of. This building is the Lamborghini, and that sign is the roof being cut off the Lamborghini. That's what we're watching. We're watching the Bam Margera show. That's what our world has become. God, that's depressing. But I got arched windows. And definitely awnings. You know, those awnings are sexy. It's like looking up a lady's skirt. I mean, look at that one. You get a good view. Okay. Moving on. Let's go over here. This is getting a little bit too Taurus-y. Look at all them Tauruses. Got Mudflood right there. Got pavement light right there. That's raised platform 2. Look at the scale. Pavement light right there. More pavement light. Everywhere pavement light. More Mudflood right there. Lots of Mudflood. Got an Etherfennial up here. Oh my gosh, we're building a steel building. I believe they had steel buildings back in the day too. I don't know why they came up with the narrative that we didn't have steel buildings. I can't figure that one out yet. I'm working on that. I don't really have. It really is pretty stupid. Why did they act like they did? It's like they wanted to have this narrative that there was some sort of evolution in architecture. Evolution is bullshit. Okay, y'all, let's just lay it out. I ain't no fucking monkey, okay? And my ancestors weren't no fucking monkey, okay? That's all horse shit. Even Darwin didn't believe Darwin's bullshit, okay? Do your research, people. Evolution. There ain't no missing link because there ain't no link, y'all. Okay, evolution's horse shit. We ain't from monkeys. We're human. God designed us perfect as we are. Okay? Get over it. There ain't no evolution. God didn't need evolution. God created us perfect. Perfect imperfection. Because we ain't perfect. Okay? We all have our flaws. I'm a flawed motherfucker. Excuse my French. I'm just Frenching out today. Excuse my French. I can't help it. I'm a sailor. Well, I'm not a sailor. If I was a sailor, I'd fit right in. I mean, look at this. The American magazine. Oh, American. America. That's Moorish looking right there. But there's that building we were looking at earlier. In case you remember that one. That big old tossing bitch. Big old Ether antenna, arched winders. I don't know where I was at. I done lost my thought. I got sidetracked by a damn arch wind and these old trolleys running around everywhere. Old world technology being brought out, running this shit with horses. I mean, can you imagine how stupid? I was watching something today. They were talking about these old trolleys and how they were pulling more horses. And like in the, was it the, in Chicago? And they were talking about how there was that I think it was like 6,000 horses were dedicated to the trolley service when they first started it. What the hell are y'all talking about? You thought it was a good idea to pull trolleys with 6,000 horses. And then they had some sort of, when they had the Chicago fire, it caused a problem because a lot of them died. And then they had some kind of disease or something. I don't know. It was really interesting. There's a channel called Ist History that I've been checking out that he does really good work and he strikes me as a mud flutter that doesn't know he's a mud flutter. So check into that channel, Ist History. He does good work. I think he comes up with interesting subjects. Anyways. Oh, okay. Let's move on. Good grief. Dirigible, New York. 1915 Navy dirigible Long Island. And a lot of people just like dirigibles, so I just thought I'd throw this in here just because people like dirigibles. Got a dirigible hangar, old airship. I think that's an old world technology. Just a thought. Philadelphia circa 1906, Chestnut Street. Wow. Check that thing out. It looks ethery. That's Boss Man. Boss Man. That's Fred. That is a pretty horse. I can appreciate that. But you know what else I can appreciate? I can appreciate more than that. I can appreciate octagon coal hole covers with pavement light in them. That's what that is right there. Those are rare. Big time rare. That's more pavement light right there. So this whole sidewalk right here is hollow. That's all vaulted underneath. In case you needed to see some pavement light today. Y'all, I don't pick these pictures out for pavement light. Now, I got thousands probably of pictures of pavement light, but these are there. I don't have to look for them. I don't like go and pick these out because I'm not like, oh, I'm gonna get that picture. It's got pavement light. No. There's those ball thingies. No, ether antenna. No, I don't do that. They just come out like that. They're just there. Check that thing out. I mean, good grief. This world is just clocks are expensive. Looks fractal antenna looking thing there. Whoop-a-do. What the hell? Look at that dude. That dude just standing. That. Okay. Well, yeah, we built this world. Yeah. I believe that when my shit turns purple, it smells like rainbow sherbet. I can't say as good as that guy. I should just insert the GIF. It's much funnier. Maybe I will. Maybe I won't. You'll never know until I do it or don't. You'll never know. Got people scooper. That literally is a people scooper. I'm not joking. That's a people scooper. Literally. They would scoop people up. It was a safety measure. Sounds funny, don't it? And big old drop into the mud flood there. I mean, because that makes sense. We're going to build a freaking moat around our building. Yep, that makes sense. Yep. And tourist fields, you know, arched windows, more tourist fields. That's part of a wind catcher system. I does believe portholes, excuse me. Ether fence, ether antenna. That's interesting right there. 1881 or I-81. Excuse me. I'm tired because I've had my head up a laptop's tail for a week. I'm exhausted. There's those ball thingies. That kind of reminds me of an owl. Maybe. Hard to tell. That's part of the wind catching system. These turning windows. It creates a vortex of air that moves through the building. It's the same effect as if you stand between two houses that are, you know, close together. You get the vortex effect. Look at that portal. There's a ladder lane. You know, if you stand between two buildings, stand between two structures, that creates a vortex. If you've ever experienced that, okay, that's what this wind catcher system does. And it's powerful. I mean, it feels like air conditioning. It's no joke. It could be 95 degrees out and you get in between a building and it's like air conditioning on you. Prince Hill Incline, part of the Cincinnati Streetcar and Freight Elevator System circa 1906. So this is another funicular. That's weird how we got this strange odd post sitting there. I don't know, it's odd. Little arched window there. Arc light. Arched windows. Ether fencing up here. Smokestack that wasn't a smokestack till we turned it into a smokestack. Then we're probably going to burn the place down. Ether antenna. That's a funicular right there. And some of these, you know, would you could drive up on like this one. Okay, this has got carts and stuff on it. And others, it had a train car on it that was fixed to it. And others, they would drive the trolley cars onto this and then drive them down and they would keep going on. There was quite a few of the funiculars around back in the day. All right, let's move on. And we got post office in Washington, D.C. in 1908. The old post office building seen from the corner of 11th Street and Pennsylvania Avenue Northwest. So I just need to know where the Pony Express drops the packages. Oh, okay. Must be right here. Because there's Fred. Fred's the horse that delivered the mail in America and built America. And, you know, so we got that worked out. I'm glad that we got that worked out. Got Boss Man here calling on the call box. That's how the law used to talk around. Of course, that might be a mailbox, but they had these boxes on the poles where the law would call around. That's how they got word around each other. And we got, you know, big old mud floody windows with a moat. You know, you got to have a moat around your post office. Mud flood windows on the base. We got to add horseshit stairs going up in this big old archway. I mean, because that makes sense. You know, on face value, you know, it looks all right. But then when you really think about it, it don't look too, you know, that dog don't hunt. I mean, that building is incredible. It's got a Moorish look to it. Oh, we definitely added that. That's something we can definitely do. All these other finials up here, clocks. Well, clocks are probably going to be expensive. Fractal antenna business here could be. Wind catching system here. Remember to catch the little GIF in the end of the video, where you can see a moving diagram of how the wind moves through the buildings. So don't miss that. Portal here. And let's see. And what else we got? That's just a beautiful building. But I mean, seriously, it's going to be like, I mean, this is like, Fred is going to, look, he's backed up delivering the mail. That's the mail. That's the post office. I mean, okay, yes, it's Washington, D.C., and yes, they probably have more mail than a lot of places, but seriously? Seriously, you need this as your post office. Because this makes sense. I mean, this is a castle, right? I mean, tell me if I'm wrong. Is that not freaking an old world castle? I don't know. I think it's now's a good time for a shameless plug.
Let's see what we got in here. Again, Stuff Beagles believes that you need to go over to this channel. And just so you know, if any of you want to be my Patreon, what I'm asking you to do is go over and be Stuff Beagle's Patreon. I'm fine. To me, Stuff Beagle is the best in the business of this Mudflood business, guys. He's doing the most unique work on proving the Mudflood, but he does believe that these are part of the technology that, with the free energy in the corners here. So kind of interesting, go check it out. And the type of video that I would recommend you watch of his is his hour plus videos. They're amazing, guys. Entertaining, you love him. Go be one of his Patreons. Give him $5 a month. The guy is putting out like 20 plus videos a month. And I'm telling you what, they're some of the highest quality videos in Mudflood. So go support him over there. I think he's got 7 Patreons right now. Give him a break, guys. Come on, go over there, watch his videos. You'll appreciate what he does and help him help you. So that's all I'm gonna say.
Again, thank you, Streets of Tartaria, Caleb. Y'all go subscribe to Caleb's channel. He's doing amazing work getting boots on the ground. He goes and he kicks the dirt and he gets, you know, into places that others aren't getting into. He's like an urban explorer mudflutter dude. He's like an urbex dude that doesn't know he's an urbex dude. He gets inside the buildings and talks to people and gets the histories of the buildings. And he's just doing some, you know, really wonderful boots on the ground research. And I think it's a blueprint for future mudflood researchers. You know, anybody out there that's wanting to start a channel, look at Caleb's work on Streets of Tartaria and use it as a blueprint to go look in your area. Do it your own way, you know. But look at how simple it is what he's doing with the camera work. And just go out and film and look. Physically look, because these pictures, you know, can only go so far. But when you get out there, like, there was an example in a recent video where he did, where he got down and there was arched windows, and then he started digging out the dirt on the side of the building with his hand, and he uncovers a whole nother arch. Well, you can't see that from a picture. You can't see that from Google Earth. You can't see that just driving around. You got to get boots on the ground and get out there and get your hands dirty. So anyways, let him be an inspiration to you. Anyways, this is Washington 1924, Helen G. Sweeney, Adolph Bush, Joseph Gallagher, Henry Glenn, Helen. Oh, Helen, who as Miss Washington represented the District of Columbia in the 1924 Miss America pageant. Okay, whoopee-doo. That is a boat car. That's a boat car. I need a boat car. It's got anchors. It's got a Phoenix. It's got a cannon. I mean, I need this son of a bitch right here. I got to get one of these, I tell you. Anheuser-Busch, that's it right there. Yeah, hold my beer. Hold my beer. I'm going in. I'm going to take the car for a swim. Oh, man. Anyways, got a boat car in front of big-ass Tartarian buildings. Because that's how we roll. And I said, Tartaria, put a dollar in the kitty. That's right. Anyways, that just cracked me up. Washington, D.C., circa 1919. And this is Union Station from the air. And we've looked at this building in my past videos. And it's obviously built for giants. But, I mean, this thing, this overhead view. Now, I'm going to tell you right now, I don't know what it is with this picture. But this picture is a little odd on the focus. You'll see what I'm saying. But we know that looking down in here that this, like, just this example of this archway here is just stupid ridiculous. Just the scale of it's, you know, absolutely ridiculous. We got eagles on balls here, which would be your phoenixes. You got fountains here, which are old world, part of the free energy system, and maybe even the heating and cooling system. I know these have, this is the ball, and these are lions here, so you got Tartarian lions there. You got something going on here, I don't know what's going on here. There is a lot of action, though. But just the scale, you know, this picture doesn't even look real. It's like a, it, you know what reminds me? It reminds me of what's called pan tilt shift. It's a form of photography where they turn the camera in a certain way, and it's called pan and tilt shift. And what it does is it shifts the lens, and it makes the world look miniature. I did some videos where I called them Zombie Land, and End of the World Zombie, something like that. Go look for videos I did Zombie Land, and they're showing pan tilt shift and video of around the world of different places. This is the train yards, trains coming in and everything. But this looks like to me. This was in 1919. They're doing pan tilt shift is what this is. To me, that's exactly what it looks like. Now, I'm not a photography, you know, expert, but I'm just telling you, in my rough, humble opinion, I think that's what that is. I mean, this right here is so, it looks so pan tilt shifty. Yeah, go back and check those videos. I wanted to show kind of the world in a different way. That's what those videos were about. I thought they were pretty cool. Anyways, just a crazy picture. And we got wrapping up our tour of Little Rock, Arkansas. Okay, ignore that part. This is Little Rock, Arkansas in 1910. Markham Street West from Maine. So let's go over here and see what we got here. Yeah. We got Boss Man right here. Fred's on the job. And we got Tauruses going all the way down. Arc lights. Men wanted for the United States Army. Oh, and today's 11/11. Today is Veterans Day. And so, hat tip to all the veterans throughout history. You went and died for the elitist so they could kill little people of different races that they wanted to exterminate. That's not your fault. That is definitely not your fault. Thank you for being brave enough to sign up or get drafted for said such, you know, duty. But in the future, we will not be needing your services. Thank you. We're going to discontinue the fucking war. Do you understand me, elitist? It's over. War is going to be exterminated from this fucking planet. Along with you and all your horse shit. I'm just letting you know now. You might as well just move on and mosey on and give up and run like hell, because it's over. Fred ain't taking his shit no more. You understand me? But anyways, salute to all the veterans. I don't agree with killing little brown people around the world that hadn't done anything to me, but that's not your fault. You're only doing a job that you signed up for, and you don't know that, you know, that's not where we need to be. As humans, we do not need to be killing other humans, okay? There are ways to negotiate problems without bullets and without knives and without fighting and killing and bombing, without smart bombs that ain't smart, without gassing people, without starving people, without genocide. Okay, this is all elitist horse shit. Okay, and the only way we're gonna stop it, you know, if the military would stand up and drop their weapons and say, hey, you know what, we're not gonna fight for you anymore. And they went home and they protected their own backyard. You know how many wars we'd have? Do you really, have you ever known a person in your whole life that's ever wanted to die fighting? Name one person. Think about that. Humans don't, we're not designed to kill each other. God didn't create us that way. You need to think about that. Look at this dude standing on the roof. These people just walk right. Look at that. Oh. Anyways, I gotta do a little rant here and there. And that is pretty work right there. Arches. It's Little Rock, Arkansas. Ain't this where old Bill the murdering Clinton is from? Old Little Rock. And that crazy batshit crazy Hillary Clinton. She's eviler than he is. Go figure that one out. Man. Bankers. Okay, what do we got? Oh, we got arches below ground. What do we got? Another arch below ground right there. You see it right there in the corner. Right there in the corner. Mm-hmm. Yep, that is an arch below ground, because that sucker is in the ground right there. Right there, you got an arched doorway right there in Little Rock, Arkansas. Little Rock, Arkansas. Yep. That's crazy. I tell you what. Won't you put that in your pipe, Mr. Contractor? This Big's out.
I know you're out there. I can feel you now. I know that you're afraid. You're afraid of us. You're afraid of change. I don't know the future. I didn't come here to tell you how this is going to end. I came here to tell you how it's going to begin. I'm going to hang up this phone, and then I'm going to show these people what you don't want them to see. I'm going to show them a world without you. A world without rules and controls, without borders or boundaries. A world where anything is possible. Where we go from there is a choice I leave to you.
mystery wrapped in a riddle inside an enigma. Don't you get it?
Say woof again! Say woof again!
I've got one that can see.
Welcome to the underground.
This is my kung fu, and it is strong.
See you later.